Okay. So we might do another one with me. Let me move. Ah, oh, yes, the microphone to be closer to me. So that I can be heard more easily. Yep, play. Now, let's see what's next. After wind, it's Canyon. Canyon does have a charger? Yeah, so Canyon does have a charger. Return to car selection. I'm gonna say that in this case, it may be better to take silencer cars, but because I'm not good with the track, I'm gonna take the Diora. Or, you know what? No, I'm just gonna try with Anthracite a bit, just to see something for some jumps. In theory, silencer should be better for this track, but practically because of how the track is, how difficult and how easy it is to get back on the track with the Teco cars, I would suggest taking a Teco car. This is a Canyon charger. The Canyon charger basically, it says that it helps you jump, but it actually floats you. It holds you up. A single player host. Canyon. So Canyon has the best track because it's go. So I'm gonna start by showing you how to cut them up because it's gonna take about a minute, maybe less. The track doesn't have a hidden car as far as I remember. You unlock battle spec though, which I cannot say it's good, but people do like it. I like the model. I don't like the driving style in 4.1 always, because things will change as far as I know. Anyway, so this track is slicks strictly all the way through. So you go forwards. This is the first turn. And if you wanna cut, you do this. I have thought that I have fallen a bit too early. You are kinda right. But I wanna do something a bit different. Yeah, so you can see the end. Being able to see the end, hear your nitrox, and you can actually time it in order to do that correctly. But other than that, you can use the XL charger, which for some reason it doesn't work right now. What the fuck? Anyway, this is the tracks. So it is what it is with your four tracks, and we fly inside. So now I'm gonna reset to mode for lean. I'm gonna add my nitrox back and we're actually gonna do the map. So basically, this track is a lot like a roller coaster ride, by the way, from the way it seems. A lot of inclines while turning, you have to be careful, there is no thing to protect you on the side of the track. So you just have to be careful. Braking while turning is not an option in this map because of the understeer and how difficult it actually is in a way to control cars with understeer. I've seen someone drift here, it's weird. Do not brake when you go here, it will destroy you. Also, I would say don't accelerate, wait for for this to start. If you go that way, then you can go normally. And you fall off. And this is why I would recommend getting a Teco car for this map. In my case, I should have gotten Kovlite or Mitrium because I am better at driving them than Anthracite. But yeah, let's move forward a bit. I would say that having a car with good downforce is a must for this track, but not too much downforce because you actually have to be able to make the jumps. There are some cars that are not going to be able to jump. Okay, and give me a second. I'm gonna change the car. I'm gonna use... Fuck it, let's use Iridium. Yeah. Anyways, what I would recommend is you using Teku. I'm gonna use silencers because I wanna show you something in the jump. After that, you're free to believe what's better for its track. For this track in general, I would say I'm not sure which accelerator would be better, but if Swamp worked, it would be up there. Anyway, you just have to be careful, not go too fast. And you continue normally. You don't brake, you don't accelerate here. Just wait to start the incline, then you go normally. And everything goes well. Remember not to brake while turning. Whatever braking you need to do, I would recommend doing it before the turn. Anyway, in this track, it's constant turning, constant curves, constant loops. So here it's... Oh, fuck. Damn it. Yeah, so as you can see, this track is pretty hard. The pretty hard is an understatement. So this is where you go. Anyway, as you can see, it is a pretty hard track. I'm gonna go back to my Diora. I cannot actually go fast to many things here without a car that I actually know how to use. So yeah. So, slicks all the way through. Be careful of the understeer and oversteer so you stay good on the car. You have to be careful of the curves and the turns and the loops and generally anything, because this track is pretty fucking hard. Look at this. I already stopped accelerating and brake a bit here in order to not fall in the vertical. Alright. This is done. And you have to be careful not to overshoot anything. And when I say overshoot, I'm talking about the jumps. And here we go to the jump. Let's not fall off before it. So what you wanna do here, so you have, yeah, so this is what happens when you use the accelerator. It actually keeps you up on the air for a bit longer, so I wouldn't have made the jump, I think, without it. But yeah, you can use the Teco jump jets to smoothen the landings on the jumps and to make the jumps that are not possibly possible. So here, I prefer going this way because after the loop, the jumps and things like that are easier, while if you take the left route, it is easier until the jump, but the jump is a lot longer, so it's pretty easy to miscalculate. So you continue here, la 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 la, break a bit to make it possible, be careful to be online with how the track goes. No, that's so bad of me. Let's go back up. This is also, as I said, why you want to take a car. I'm already back up. And you go here. Go from here to here, but instead of doing that, let's actually see how this part of the track goes. It's pretty easy, it's going well, but there is this fucking huge jump. I'm gonna go on the other side to help you realize how big this jump is. What the fuck? Oh, good thing, Sector. I like you more. So, what has happened there is that Sector has put water physics on it. order to make it easier to land it. So let's go forwards. I'm just gonna skip everything towards it to show you what I mean. Come on, let's go back up. Okay. So we're back again. This is how you would do it with the jump jets. Pretty easy, right? You continue. Second gear, best gear. Just in time. So now we'll go left. See, it's easier because it doesn't have a loop. Vroom vroom. That's a bit tricky. Anyway, in this map you go sideways a lot, as you can see. And here is the jump. It may have seemed easier, but if you actually saw it, I would have overshot it if the water hadn't caught me exactly how it should have been. Generally, it's a pretty hard one. For a bit I thought this was a jump, but this is the jump, and this is where those two the tracks reconnect. If you go too fast here while you're low on downforce, you fly, which is something that you do not want to do. And so this is the boost that in my opinion should always be okay. I cannot believe I'm still on the fucking track. Technically I'm not on the fucking track. So yeah, I shouldn't have talked. So anyway, after you get on the booster, you wanna use the brakes. Come on. Okay, here it is. You wanna use the brakes to not actually get off the track. And then it's cool, nothing much happening. There's a small jump here, nothing to be afraid of. The brakes. There is the turn, nothing much. Okay, this is one of my favorite loops that Hot Wheels tracks used to have. Let me use this. Okay, so now you will see that I have reset, but the reason I have reset is because I want to lose as little time as possible to show you the rest of the track. Because I remember exactly where I have to go to be on this seat. And if you remember correctly, there is the end. Anyway, so let's get on this piece of track. Here you go. We wanna go fast. Be careful on the loops because you lose grip. Do not brake well vertically. And then you just have to be careful. Be careful here. Use the brakes just bit, you tap them from time to time. Whew, everything is going well. Yay. And then this. And here you are in another fork. And this time it doesn't actually matter which one you'll take. I usually take the left, this time I'm taking the right. It's actually the exact same thing this point. Because this is what they do. They reconnect a bit, you do two loops around the mountain, loops, anyway, whatever those are. Here is a normal loop, be careful to not fall off on it. It is over. And then you just jump into the portal and you have battle spec. And I face through everything. It doesn't matter. Anyway. And that's that. I think I explained things as far as I wanted to do. So yeah. That's nice.